children, what are possessive nouns? Words that tell us about the possession of a noun are called possessive nouns. Or words that show possession or ownership is called possessive nouns. They are written by adding an apostrophe. And see, this is an apostrophe, an image of apostrophe. And an S is also added to the noun. Singular possessive noun is there and plural possessive noun is there. Now, singular possessive nouns tell us about possessions of one noun. And plural possessive nouns tell us about the possessions of more than one noun. So, we use an apostrophe to show possession. Now, in case of singular possessive noun, we use apostrophe and an S with the noun. But in case of plural nouns, plural possessive noun, if the noun ends with S, if the plural noun ends with S, then we add only apostrophe after the letter S. But if the plural noun ends with the letter, does not end with the letter S, then we put the apostrophe sign before S. That is just like singular noun, apostrophe and S. Let us see few examples. See the first example of singular possessive noun. Ron's car is in the garage. Whose car is in the garage? The car belongs to whom? Ron. So, Ron is a singular noun. Therefore, you can see that we are adding apostrophe and then an S with the noun Ron to make it a possessive noun. That is R-O-N apostrophe S. Ron's car is in the garage. See the next example. Whose notebook is lying on the table? Tom's notebook is lying on the table. So, in the same way, after Tom, we add an apostrophe and S to denote possessive noun. That is to denote possession. Next, you see, John's wife is a doctor. J-O-H-N-S. So, John is a name of a person which is a noun. Whose wife? John's wife. So, to denote possession, we add an apostrophe and S with the noun, that is John. So, it becomes John's wife is a doctor. Now, if you see rule number 3, suppose if a noun is in singular form, but that particular noun ends with the letter S, so already S is there. So again, if we add apostrophe and S, then a hissing sound will come. Now, to avoid that hissing sound, what is done is, after S, only apostrophe is added. Another S is not added. Why? To avoid that hissing sound. See the example. Teja's school is in Malviya Nagar. Now, Teja's, this is the full name. The name ends with the letter S. So, this is a noun which ends with the letter S. So, already S is there. Therefore, you will add only apostrophe after the S. Suhas, teacher, Suhas, sister is a teacher. In this word Suhas, already it is ending with S. Therefore, to avoid the hissing sound, we add only the apostrophe after the S. Now, just in the similar way, in case of plural noun, if the noun ends with S, for example, boys, girls, it already ends with the letter S. So, in that case, the apostrophe should be used after S. And in case of plural noun which does not end with S, then in that word we use an apostrophe and an S, just as we did in singular noun, singular possessive noun. See the example. The student's report card is ready. Students. So it is ending with the letter S. Therefore, we only add an apostrophe after the S. Now you see the next sentence. Girls' dance class has been postponed. So girls, already S is there. Therefore, we just put an apostrophe after S. But in case of irregular pronoun like children, people, both are ending with N, and in people, children is ending with N, people is ending with E. They are not ending with S. Therefore, in that case, we put apostrophe and then an S. I hope now it's clear to you and you understand how to use the apostrophe and an S in case of singular possessive nouns and plural possessive nouns. You have to keep these points in mind. And simple way to remember is that if the word ends with S, then just an apostrophe after the S. If the word ends with any other letter other than S, except S, then you have to put an apostrophe and an S.